W is equal to B into Q divided by M here. In the presence of magnetic field B, charge is moving like a spherical scale, like this. This one is magnetic field. Okay. This when charge moved in helical spring. We know the angular frequency omega is equal to 2 pi by t. When we take it, t is equal to 2 pi by omega, t is the time period. T is the time period for a one revolution. T is equal to 2 pi by omega is the time period for making one revolution of a charged particle. Okay, now see, here we are considering a charge, any one charge in the presence of a magnetic field B here. Where t is equal to 2 pi by omega is the time period for the revolution of a one, for the one revolution here. Okay, next, when, see here, at this point we are having a velocity, when the velocity is parallel to the magnetic field B. When velocity is parallel to the magnetic field B, then the charge formed a helical spring shape, means formed a helical spring here. When the velocity is parallel to the magnetic field, the charge moving in the form of helical spring type here. Okay. And it forms a pitch P. So it, this one is okay. Are you getting? See here. And here we are considering a magnetic field B. In this magnetic field, we are considering a one charge. That charge is moving here. At that time, when the charge is moving, means it is when the velocity is parallel to the magnetic field B. This velocity is, velocity means the speed of a charge. The speed of a charge is parallel to the magnetic field B. Then it charge forms a helical spring type that forms a number of helical spring that forms a pitch P. That pitch P is called a the distance moved along a magnetic field here. Okay, see the definition of pitch. The distance moved along the magnetic field, moved along the magnetic field, along the magnetic field in one rotation. Along the magnetic field in one rotation is called a pitch. The definition of pitch is, say, the distance moved along the magnetic field in a one rotation. Means after the one rotation, the distance between the rotation is called a pitch here. Okay, that P, the pitch is represented by that. That formula is P is equal to velocity when parallel to the magnetic field P and time period T here. Okay, when the helical spring is formed, after the helical spring only we can say that there is a pitch is formed here. Okay, the helical spring is formed when the velocity is parallel to the magnetic field B here. Okay, the time period of a revolution, that is 2 pi by omega. Now P is equal to Vp divided by T, where we know the formula of T. T we derived the first one. In before that we derived P is equal, T is equal to 2 pi m divided by Qb. Put this value in this equation. T is equal to 2 pi m divided by Qb. Next we get P is equal to Vp into, sorry, 2 pi m into Vp divided by Qb. It is the formula of a pitch. See here, what we find? We take a charge in the presence of a magnetic field when the velocity is parallel to the magnetic field. Velocity means the charge velocity. Velocity means speed of a charge. It is parallel to the magnetic field. It forms a helical spring. After forming the helical spring, it is having a pitch. The distance between two helical spring here. This forms a pitch. After that, we find the formula for a pitch, that P is equal to, when pitch P is formed, when the magnetic field B is parallel to the velocity Vp into T here, with a time revolution. T is a revolution of a time for one period. To complete a one period, the revolution of time is T is equal to 2 pi m divided by Q. Sorry, Q into B. That is P is equal to 2 pi m Vp whole divided by Qb. Okay. Next, see here we are having a radius R. Where the radius R of a circular motion. Radius R of a circular motion is called a radius of helix. Is called a radius of helix. When it is forming a helical circular motion, it forms a radius here like this. That radius R is called a radius of a helix here. Okay, this one is all about the motion in a magnetic field when the charged particle moving perpendicular to the magnetic field. When the charged particles are moving perpendicular to the magnetic field B here. In inward direction, we find this one. Okay. Next, we are having a motion in a combined electric and magnetic field. Magnetic field. motion in a combined electric and magnetic field here. Okay. See here. In earlier class, mean before classes, we studied that when the charge moves in the presence of both electric field E and electric field E, electric field is represented by the symbol E and the magnetic field represented by the symbol B here. In the previous class, we studied that when the charge moves in the presence of a both electric field and magnetic field B, the experience of a force. What is the experience of a force here? When charge moves, we already know the when charge moves in the presence of an electric field. In the presence of electric field E, the charge moves means that having a that experiences force. It is moving with a velocity v. When charge is moving with a velocity v, that experiences Q charge moves with velocity v, that experiences sum of forces. That experiences sum of forces. That force is in the presence of electric field E. In the presence of electric field E, when charge moves with the velocity v, in the presence of electric field E means experiences E is equal to F is equal to Q into E. F is the force, Q is the charge, E means electric field E. Okay. When in the presence of magnetic field B, in the presence of magnetic field also charge moves with the velocity B. Only in the presence of magnetic field B, then the equation is F is equal to Q into V cross B, vector V cross B. Okay, it can be written as F E is equal to Q into E here, and this one is F M is equal to Q into vector V cross vector B. Okay, this is when the charge is moving with the velocity v in the presence of an electric field E here, and this is when the charge is moving with the velocity v in the presence of a magnetic field B here. Now what we are studying here, motion in a combined electric and magnetic field B here, means when the charge is moving in both electric and magnetic field, what is the equation? This force F is equal to in the presence of electric field plus in the presence of magnetic field. What will be the equation of F E? In the presence of electric field, force is Q into vector E plus force in the presence of magnetic field B. That is Q into vector B cross B here. Okay. Q is common, where vector E plus B cross B. Now this is the equation of a force when the charge is moving in both electric field E and in the presence of magnetic field B. Okay. Now here we are considering a electric field E and magnetic field B and velocity E. This is Y, this is X, and this one is Z. Okay. Electric field E moves in this direction and magnetic field B in a Z direction, and velocity V in a X direction. Okay. The equation is F is equal to Q into E plus vector B cross vector B. This one is the equation when the charge in the both electric and magnetic field be here. Now, here we consider the case in which both electric field, magnetic field and velocity, where electric field E moves in the y direction, magnetic field B moves in the z direction and velocity B moves in the x direction here. Okay. Now, in which case the electric field E is perpendicular to the magnetic field? No, see here, the electric field E is perpendicular to the magnetic field and where B, magnetic field B is perpendicular to the electric field and both electric field B and magnetic field, electric field E and magnetic field B are perpendicular to the velocity B here. Okay. Now consider the case in which electric field E and magnetic field B are perpendicular to each other. Both electric field and magnetic field B are perpendicular to each other and both electric field E and magnetic field B and also perpendicular to the velocity B here. Velocity V. Okay. In which we are considering a velocity V along x axis and E is along y axis and next magnetic field B is along z axis. Now we can write the component of x, y, z as a vector V is equal to V I cap vector E is equal to E j cap vector B is equal to B K cap. Now see, basically we know the electric field, the force experienced on the, in the presence of electric field F is equal to Q into V and the presence of magnetic field F is equal to V cross Q into V cross V here. Now in the case of electric field, magnetic field and velocity V here, in this case both electric field and magnetic field both are perpendicular to each other and both electric field and magnetic field both is perpendicular to the velocity V here. Now we are considering it. Velocity in the x direction, magnetic field in the z direction and electric field in the y direction. Okay. Now we are consider the components. It is V is equal to vector V is equal to V I cap, vector E is equal to E j cap, vector B is equal to B k cap. Now see here. The electric force, electric force on charged particle is, the electric force on a charged particle is F E is equal to F force in the presence of electric field. Electric field experiences force F, that is Q into vector E here. Okay. Now we have the value of vector B, that is this one. Vector E is equal to E into J cap. Q is equal to vector E is equal to E into J cap. This one is the electric field. Sorry, this one is the force experienced by the charge in the presence of electric field B here. Sorry, electric field E here. This along y-axis means the electric field in the along y-axis. Along y-axis. Okay. This similarly, we have to find the about magnetic field. Therefore, the magnetic force. The magnetic force on charged particle. This one is magnetic force. The magnetic force on a charged particle. We know the formula. F m is equal to q into vector b cross vector b. Okay. We know magnetic force on a charged particle. Magnetic force on a charged particle is q into vector b cross vector b here. Okay. Now put the value of vector b. We know the value of vector b and vector b here. Okay. What is the value of vector b? B I cap. Vector b is b k cap. With q into vector b value is b I cap cross vector b value is b k cap. Okay. Next, q into v into b with I cap cross k cap value is I cap cross k cap value is what is the value of I cross k cross? We know I cross I is equal to 1, j cross j is equal to 1, k cross k is equal to 1, but we are having I cross k means when I cross J is equal to 1, J cross K is equal to, sorry, I cross J is equal to K, J cross K is equal to R. If two components are crossing means another component is in positive form. When it is negative means when J is first and cross, I is second means that is K is negative here. Okay. J cross K and K cross I, that is J. Okay. I cap, J cap, these are mentioned by the caps. Okay. Next, but we are having the values of I cross J as K, J cross K as I, K cross I as J. But we want the value of I cross K here. But here there is no I cross K value. But the value of I cross K is this I cross K vector I cap. Sorry, I cap cross K cap is the value is minus J here. Means it is also when K cap into J cross K J cap is equal to I minus and J cap cross I cap is equal to minus K here. Means now we got the value of I cross I cap cross K cap. That we have the I cap cross K cap, that value is minus J here. Put the value of I cap cross K cap, that is minus J here. Minus J cap. That is QVB to minus J cap along negative of the Y axis. See it. consider the velocity in x direction, magnetic field in a z direction, and electric field in a y direction. Okay. After considering this all, we take the components. This x I here, I, j, and k. Okay. Next, first we find the electric field, means electric force on a charged particle. That is F is equal to q into E. Okay, F is equal to q into vector E. When it is a vector E, means we have the value of vector E. Vector E is equal to E into j cap. After putting the value of q, E, j cap, sorry, vector E value, we get the value of q into E into j cap here. It is along a y axis. We take along, having it along y axis. Next, again we consider the charge experienced by the magnetic force. Along the magnetic force, when charge, the force experienced by the magnetic force, that is formula is Fm is equal to q into v cross b. Here already we find out the both velocity vector v and vector b values. Vector b value is vi and vector b value is vi and vector b value is bk here, bk cap. Okay. After getting the formula of magnetic force on a charged particle, that is Fm is equal to, sorry, magnetic force on a charged particle equal to q into v cross b here. Next, Fm is equal to, we know the value of vector b, that is vi cap. We put the value of vi cap and bk cap. These are the values of vector v and vector b here. After that, q, v, b are taking on one side, and I cross, I cap cross k cap we are having. We know the value of I cross k cross by the vector chapter in the mathematics. That is q, v, b is equal to, in first year also you already studied about this point, a vector I cap cross k cap, that is minus j cap, that is q, v, b into minus j. It is along y axis. How it is, means in the four quadrants we are having it, x axis along positive, x axis along negative. Easily we can say that it is along positive, y axis is y axis along negative here. Now we get the negative of them. We are taking a components I, j, z here, sorry, I, j, k here, where j is in a positive, means minus j means it comes under it, y axis along negative. Then we can say that force on a magnetic field Fm is equal to QVB minus J is along minus y axis. Okay. Next, see here, both electric field and magnetic field are in opposite direction. After that, yeah, both electric field and magnetic field are opposite direction. Then both, now both electric field and magnetic field, our values are adjusted like that, means they have to be equal. After adjusting the value of both electric field and magnetic field are in opposite direction, means after adjusting the value, we get, that is QE is equal to, QE is equal to Q into VB, Q into VB, where QQ get cancelled, E is equal to V into B here, here, or we can write V is equal to E divided by B. B is the velocity, E is the electric field, and B is the magnetic field B here. Therefore, the above condition shows that this condition, V is equal to E divided by B, it is used for a selected charged particle for a particular velocity from moving charge with a different speeds. This condition is used for a particular charged particle with moving with a velocity V with different speeds here. Okay. The equation V is equal to E by B is used to select a charged particle, is used to, when it is used, means it is used to select a charged particle select a charged particle of particular velocity of particular velocity from charges moving with a different speed. This using for a particular velocity from charges moves with different speeds. Different speed. Then it is use the equation V is equal to E divided by. That's why it is called a velocity selector. Therefore, it is called velocity selector. The equation after adjusting the value of magnetic field E and electric field E and B are in opposite direction. After adjusting the values of electric field and magnetic field B, we got the equation QE is equal to Q into VB, that is E is equal to V into B. After that we take V is outside and E divided by B here. It is equation 1. Then equation where it is used means for a selected charged particle of a particular velocity. V is the velocity here, E is the magnetic field, E is the electric field and B is the magnetic field. It is used to select a charged particle of a particular velocity where it moves from a different speed. Means it selects for a particular velocity that are different speeds. Means the charges moves in a different speed. That's why it is called a velocity selector. Means it selects the charged particle for a different particular velocity. Of a particular velocity from changes moves with different speed. Okay. This is about a motion in a combined electric field. In motion in a combined electric field, we find the F is equal to QE, this equation. F is equal to Q into E plus B cross B. Okay. This one is normally we find the motion of an electric field in the presence of electric field and magnetic field B here. Okay. Next, we consider one case in which the electric field E is moving along Y axis, velocity is moving along X axis and magnetic field is moving along Z axis. And we all take the components, that is I, J, K vectors. Okay. Next, by considering that term, we already know the force in the presence of electric field is F is equal to Q into vector E. We take the value of vector E is equal to E J cap. Okay. After putting the value of E, we get the positive of the F is equal to Q into E into J. When in the presence of electric field, it is a positive wave. Okay. Similarly, now we consider in the presence of a magnetic field B here. We already know in the presence of magnetic field, F is equal to Q into B cross B here. Okay. Same, we put the value of V and J. V is along X axis, it is having a component V I cap cross B K cap. The Q into V cross, Q V into B, that is I cap cross K cap, that is value is minus J here. Now we got the value of force in the presence of the magnetic field is minus here. Okay. Both electric field and magnetic field are in opposite direction. It is along negative of the y axis and it is along positive of the y axis here. Now after that, after adjusting the values of the electric field and magnetic field, then we got the equation E is equal to V and V, that is V is equal to E divided by V is called a velocity selector. velocity selector. Why it is called a velocity selector means it is used means it select a charge particle for a particular velocity of a different speed. That's why it is called a velocity selector. Okay, next we are having a Biot-Savart's law. Now see it. After the motion in a combined electric and magnetic field, next the topic is Biot-Savart's law. Biot-Savart's law is an experimental law which can deal with a magnetic field at a point due to a current element. Please study it for a magnetic field at a point due to a current element. Okay. Now, this is an experimental law. Consider a one conductor of infinite length. Okay. And the current I is moving along the conducting wire. Consider a conducting wire of, it is an experimental law. Okay, Biot-Savart's law is an experimental law in which we are considering an infinite length of a conducting wire. Then the current is moving current is moving through it. For example, consider this as X and Y length of a wire. Okay. Now it is having a small amount of length when the current is moving from Y to X. Now we are considering it, for example here, after considering the conducting wire, we are considering a point P, okay, in which we have to find the, in Biot-Savart's law, we have to find the magnetic field at a point P here. Okay, magnetic field at point P means here we are having a conducting wire. That is, conducting wire means it allows electricity to pass through them. Means how much means the velocity, sorry, in the how much area it is having a magnetic field B here. Okay, in which the current is moving here, we have to find the magnetic field dB at a point P here. When the current is moving from Y to X, now we are considering it the small length here. Now consider a small length dl. It is having a total length L, but we are considering when the current is moving in this direction, we consider the length current I and the length is dl. We have to find the magnetic field at a point P. When the current is flowing from Y to X direction, we are considering a one current element. Now we are taking name as AB here. Okay, that is having a length dl and current I. After that, the point P is placed at a distance from the conducting wire is R square. This place at a distance R square, it produces an angle theta. Okay. This is a Biot-Savart's law. It is an experimental law in which we are considering a infinite of a conducting wire of length L, and we consider a point P at a some distance to the conducting wire L. Now when the current is flowing from y to x direction. The current is flowing from y to x direction. Now we are considering it one small element. It is the length of a conducting wire is L, but we are considering it small element, small length, that is dl. We are considering here that dl is, we are naming that as a and b here. And the distance, the point P is placed at that distance from the current element is r square, and it produces an angle theta here. Okay. Now the product of current and length dl is called a current element here. Now a current element is a is totally called a current element. From A to B it is a current element. Current element is a product of current I and a small length dl, and a length dl, it will be small length. It is a small length here. Okay. Now it is perpendicular to the magnetic field PL. Okay. Point P is perpendicular to the current element. The current element is a product of current and a small length dl. Due to the small length dl, it is called a current element here. We are having a current element AB, and the current is moving in this direction at a point P. Point P is placed at a distance of r square. Okay. Next, in which CL, what we have to find in Pythagoras law? We have to find a magnetic field at a point P here. Okay. Therefore, see, Pythagoras law says some laws. Means it is having a law in which the first point says that Pythagoras law is directly, sorry, in the Pythagoras law, the first point says that the magnetic field dB directly proportional to the current. Means when the current is increases, the magnetic field also increases. If there is no current, when the charge is at rest, means sorry, when there is no current, means there is no magnetic field applied here. Okay. When the current increases, the magnetic field also increases. That's why say that magnetic field is directly proportional to the current I. Okay. Similarly, the second point says that dB means magnetic field. Magnetic field is represented by B. Why we are taking dB means it is a small magnetic field. Why it is small magnetic field means we are considering a small current element of a length small dl. We are considering a small length of a current element. That's why the magnetic field also we are considering small magnetic field when dB is. Magnetic field is directly proportional to the current, and it is directly proportional to the length also dl. How it is directly proportional means when the length is increases, the current is more. When the current is more, the magnetic field is more. Means the magnetic field is directly proportional to the length. And the third point says that magnetic field is directly proportional to the angle sin theta when it produces a angle produces between point P and a current element, that angle sin theta. And the fourth point says that magnetic field B is inversely proportional to the 1 divided by r square. How it is inversely proportional means, see here, we are having a point P here. For example, see here, the Pythagoras law says that magnetic field is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between point P and a current, sorry, point P and a wire, conducting wire. How it is means, in Coulomb's law we studied that is force Q1 and Q2 is directly proportional and inversely proportional. proportional to the square of the distance between them. In the same way, for example, take a magnet here and take iron pieces. When iron pieces take close nearer to the magnet, it will attract. When it takes away from the magnet, it will produce an electric field. When iron pieces comes near to the magnetic field, it produces an electric field here. Okay. When the iron pieces takes away from the magnetic field, there is no electric field. The electric field is looser. Means there is no strong electric field. The electric field becomes weaker here. In the same way, we are considering a magnetic field B at a point B, in which here the magnetic field B is inversely proportional. When it is inversely proportional, means inversely proportional to the square of the distance between. Means we are having a current element here and the distance, point P is here. When the distance between point P and a current element is less, there is a more of magnetic field B here. Okay. When the magnetic field B increases, means the distance must and should also decreases here. Okay. If the magnetic field B is decreases, means the distance will be larger. Means the distance between point P and the current element will be larger here. That's why dB is directly proportional to the 1 divided by R square. Okay. After combining the equation, these are the points of a Bio Savart's law. The first point says that magnetic field is directly proportional to the current. Otherwise, you can say magnetic field is directly proportional to the current element. We know the current. What is current element? Current element is a product of current and a small length dl here. Okay. Magnetic field is directly proportional to the current I, and second point is magnetic field is directly proportional to the small length dl, and the third point is magnetic field is directly proportional to the angle between sin theta, this angle between point P and the current A here, current element AB. And similarly, the fourth last point says that magnetic field is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Means the magnetic field is increases, the distance will be decreases here. If the magnetic field is decreases, the distance between point P and a current element is increases here. After combining all these equations, what we get? See here, dB is equal to, combine equation 1, 2, 3, 4. Combine equation 1, 2, 3 and 4. After combining the equation, dB is equal to I into dl into sin theta. All are directly proportional to the magnetic field, and R square is only inversely proportional to the magnetic field B here. It is dB is directly proportional to I dl sin theta divided by R square. For removing a proportional constant, proportionality, we are taking a constant. dB is equal to K into I dl sin theta divided by R square. Okay. Where R is a constant. K is a constant, proportionality constant. That value is K is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi. Mu naught means permeability. The value of K is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi. What is mu naught means? Mu naught is a permeability. Okay. Now put the value of a that will become magnetic field B is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi I into dl into sin theta divided by R square. This is the magnetic field formula. dP is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi idl sin theta. Mu naught is the permeability, I is the current, dl is the small length, where the product of current and length is dl. Small length dl is called current element. Sin theta is the angle between point P and the current element AB. R square is the distance between point P and the current element here. dB is the small magnetic field B here. Now we have a dB is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi I dl sin theta r cap divided by r square. Okay. Now we can write r cap, unit vector. We know unit vector. Unit vector r cap is equal to r divided by magnitude of r here. Okay, vector r divided by, unit vector r cap is equal to vector r divided by magnitude of r. This shows the direction of the current here. Okay, shows the direction. Where unit vector r cap is equal to vector r divided by r, b is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi I into dl sin theta. R cap is vector r divided by magnitude of r. This is also in magnitude. When both in magnitude means it will becomes r cube. Okay, r cube, that is mu naught divided by 4 pi. dB is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi I into dl, vector dl, vector r into sin theta divided by r cube. Sin theta divided by r cube. Okay. Now we can write equation 6. Consider this as equation 6. This is the formula of a magnetic field. Okay, next we take a direction here, direction of the current in the current conducting wire, that r cap, where r cap is a unit vector. Formula of unit vector is r vector r divided by r. After putting the value of r cap, r vector r divided by r, r square become r cube, because it is in magnitude of, before only it is in magnitude, now r magnitude, r square into r cap here, and I into dl vector r into sin theta divided by r cube. By using this equation, we can write dB is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi I into vector r cross vector dl divided by r cube. How it is means, see here. Vector A cross vector B is equal to AB sin theta. Okay. Here we have vector dl cross vector r into sin theta. Means it will become in this form. That is vector dl cross vector r. Okay. That is vector r cross vector dl. This is the final equation for a magnetic field in the presence of, this is the final equation of a Biot-Savart's law. It is also called Laplace law. Okay. dP is equal to mu naught divided by 4. It is also magnetic field, it is also Biot-Savart's law. Mu naught divided by 4 pi idl sin theta divided by r square. After that we consider the equation, means the direction of a radius, means the point. To find the magnetic field at a point P, we consider the direction, that is r cap. That one becomes dB is equal to, final equation becomes dB is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi I into vector r cross vector dl divided by r cube. This is equation of a Biot-Savart's law. Next, we have a unit and dimensional formula. Unit and dimensional of a Biot-Savart's law. That will continue in next class. Okay. This is totally about Biot-Savart's law. I will continue in next class.